Hey dear subscribers and viewers, thanks for tuning in. Today we're going to do a little comparison of sorts between the Omega Planet Ocean 2201.50 42mm 2500D movement and the Rolex Submariner reference 16610. Now I know that these are not so comparable, I know, but still, I think that I've read on the internet, I'm influenced by the internet, I read that some comparison saying that is this PO the 16610 of Omega? Is it the OG? Is it like the OG? Is it like the 5-digit Submariner? So that's why I'm making this video, to try and think out loud if it is. Spoiler, it isn't, but just to see them. I mean, they're both sports watches, they both have date complications, they have bracelets. I'm gonna show the bracelet as well, but okay, let's flip the camera around and start talking watches, eh? Okay, so we have a little comparison here. On the right we have the Submariner Rolex 16610. On the left we have the Omega Planet Ocean, reference 2201.50. Two classic watches, considered very highly in their respective companies, and collectors love them. So which one is the OG? That's a good question. The Planet Ocean is based on the past Omega Seamaster models. And as you can see, it has a nice 12, 9, 6 configuration, which really contributes to the vintage aesthetic. But at the same time, if you take a look at the bezel insert, in my opinion, it's very, very sporty. Then you have all the info about the movement, you know, the coaxial movement, which wasn't around in 1957. So, I mean, it's a mix of things. And also we have an applied logo, very nicely applied. Very nice. Submariner is a different story. It's a vintage watch, okay? I'm gonna say something which can be quite I don't know, people are gonna disagree with me, but it's a vintage watch in a modern package, if that makes sense. They made this watch in 1953, they changed it a little, changed. I think in 1960 or 61 or 62, they started to look like this, and since then they look like this. Say for the new one, which the ceramic one. But before that, it was always built like this. So this is a 5-digit Submariner. It's the OG, you know? And it looks like it's from the 50s, with these round white gold circles for the hour markers, and that Swiss made at the bottom, and that bezel. Everything is very, very functional here. It's a tool watch. And so is the Omega Planet Ocean, you know? It's very tooly. You have the date at 3 o'clock, date complication, also on the Worley. You see? Today is the 21st of September. So both of, you know, now both are polished on the lugs brushed on the lugs and polished on the sides, which is a popular choice for divers. Okay, this one is also polished and also brushed, so very, very nice. I'm trying to get it to focus. Don't want to focus. Okay, anyway, you're gonna trust me on this. You're gonna have to trust me on this. So yeah, very, very nice. Bezels. Oof. Very nice bezel action on the Planet Ocean. Ocean from Timeless Watch Channel. Here is also pretty good on the Submariner. But I prefer the Planet Oceans, to be completely honest, okay? Both bezels are aluminium, so you can get them scratched, and then they will look rugged, and they will look like they were used and worn with love by you. Bracelets, okay, the bracelet on the 16610 is very, very comfortable. It's a three-link configuration. You have that cheap clasp, which is pressed, but then you have a very nice links, and they are brushed and they're held by screws. So yeah, it's a great bracelet. I really love it. It's very classic. It's the Oyster bracelet. Now the Planet Ocean bracelet is also three link configuration, but it's a little more sporty, a little more daring, more as you can see, this bracelet has seen some wear. It might seem so, but all the parts of the bracelet are brushed. Some people polish theirs, but I don't like it. The sides are polished. It's a very comfortable bracelet. I can't wait to get the links for it so I can wear it again on the watch.